My name is Sammy Daps, a white private eye in Mumubuti, Africa. When millionaire Howard H. Farnsworth hired me to find a jungle queen, that's when it all started. Farnsworth seemed a little strange when he stepped into my office, but after he advanced me a good chunk of dough, I took the job. I left Farnsworth at the railroad station and started into the jungle to find a queen. A couple of days into my search, I came across this pygmy village. The chief dressed up in a six-button beanie, looking like a cool fool in the water pool. Must have been no bigger than 2'6". In pygmies, I asked him,
"Katanga huka manga huka cha, why you? Katanga huka manga huka cha, why you? Katanga huka manga huka cha, why you? Where's that jungle queen?"
The chief said he didn't know. He was lying. As I was about to leave, his bird sound cut through me like a slugm of 45. To find that bird meant to find the queen. I moved into the marshes with a jungle steam. Again that bird sound whistled through. I was closer to the queen now, that I knew. The pygmies frozen in terror started to dance to the katanga, cuckoo, cha-cha. All right, everybody, let's dance. In the heart of the woods. I finally left the marshes and made it to some flatland. I kept thinking why I took this job and that guy Farnsworth who wanted a jungle queen. Now, bitten and battered, my trench coat was tattered, my fedora was all in shreds. I stumbled through the jungle trying not to take a tumble to find where that bird led. Then it happened. I saw this weird-looking bird. It flew round and round, very close to the ground, till it finally flew into itself. Too tired out to crawl about, I kept in mind the pygmy rhyme. Thank you. still. I pulled out my .45 and entered the hut. I held my rod tightly in my sweaty hands so no one could grab it. And there it was, the Jungle Queen. I had found the Jungle Queen. The Queen, mumbling something, took my rod and wouldn't let go. I knew what the Queen was trying to say. Loving you means never having to say you're sorry.